Why does my Windows program slow down and eventually stop working? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's get right to this question. It's an interesting one. What's going on in my Windows 10 32 gigabytes of memory PC after assembling a few hundred photo files in Lightroom Classic into a slideshow? It slows down, the external drive shows constant activity, etc., and the program just stops working while outwardly seeming to be okay. How can I trace the problem when Task Manager seemingly is showing all is well, only half of memory is occupied? Is there some info from Task Manager about operations I could get that I don't know about? Is it related to the external hard drive? Clear to me something is overloaded. It's happening after about an hour of this work. I have to take notes of where I am, sign out of Lightroom, restart, and hope for the best. Unnerving and a waste of time. Something's overloaded, all right. And as you've already identified, it ain't RAM. You've got plenty of RAM. Exactly what might be going on depends on the program you're using at the time this happens. Now, we're going to start first by not assuming that it's Lightroom in your case. We're going to basically say, let's find out which program is causing all of this. And we're going to do that with a different tool. Task Manager has a lot of interesting information. Resource Monitor, which is also included in Windows, has more. I'm going to click on the Start menu and just start typing Resource Monitor, and you see that it shows up. Resource Monitor is the tool we want to fire up. I'm going to click on that, and you'll see that it comes up with an interesting display of various aspects of this computer's resource usage. I'm expanding the window here so that we can see all of the different things that are listed. Since you indicated that your external hard disk was in constant activity, we're going to take a look at how to find out what program is causing that. So you can see one of the areas here is disk. What I'm going to do is I'm clicking on total bytes. If we could make this a little wider if you like. But the concept here is that by clicking on this column header, we are sorting this information by the software program that is currently writing or reading the most. Now, right now, I don't have a whole lot going on. You can see here that it's spending a little bit of time on the swap file, the paging file. There's an NTFS file being used. These are all being done by the system. So to get some example disk activity, I'm going to run command prompt. Now to do this, I'm going to need to run it as administrator. So I'll right click and say run as administrator. We'll click on yes. What I'm going to do is I'm going to run check disk without any parameters, so that it simply tries to check all of the files, all of the folders on this disk to make sure that they're okay. It's a disk heavy activity. I'm going to hit enter, and then I'm going to immediately switch over to resource monitor so we can see what the impact is. Now you can see that right away check disk comes to the top of the busiest program using the disk, and you can see here which file it actually happens to be working on at the time. It's switching around. You can see because disk activity comes and goes, you can see that this list changes in order, but you can see that check disk is at the top, and you can see which file it's using at the top of that list. What I want you to do is when you find yourself in this situation, I want you to fire up Resource Manager, come to this display, click on the total column so that it gets sorted by the most active program at the top of the list, and see what program that is. You'll probably find that it's Lightroom. I don't doubt that. But because there are other possibilities, anything from the system indexer to your security software, I'd like to rule those out first. This will tell you who's using the disk the most right now. So having done that, and having come back to Lightroom as probably being the issue, then what do we do next? Well, then it starts to get a little weird. I will say at the outset, I am a little uncomfortable with your having all of your photos being accessed by Lightroom on an external disk. We'll see why here in a minute. The issue is that many programs will keep temporary files, swap files, intermediate files on the same drive that your data files are kept on. What that means is that while that program is working, it's trying to access all of those files at the same time. That can really be hitting the hard disk really, really hard. In your case, that's all going through a USB interface, which is going to be slower than an internal drive. So the first thing I want you to check is to make sure that your USB interface is USB 3 or better. If it's USB 2, honestly, I think we're done. That's probably your problem. But if it's USB 3, then we can move on. You can easily tell most of the time whether or not the interface is USB 3 by the connector, the color of the inside of the connector, the little plastic piece being blue. That needs to be blue both on the device you're connecting to, your hard disk in this case, and the socket in which you're plugging it into in your computer. They're blue. It's probably USB 3. If it's a USB C connector, the one you can plug in either way and it works, then that's also USB 3 or better. You're fine. So check the USB interface first. If that's the problem, if that's getting in the way, solve that. The other thing to look at then is program settings. Like I said, many programs will default to having their temporary files, their intermediary files on the same drive as your data files. Look for options. Now, in Lightroom specifically, because I did install it, Lightroom doesn't have those kind of options. That's unfortunate. I'd rather be able to say, put the temporary files on this drive, have the data files on that drive, so that as you're working, they don't interfere with one another. Not an option from Lightroom, from what I can tell. The other issue I have with Lightroom specifically that I think really does probably factor into your case is that Lightroom is looking at more than just your photos. They're actually keeping what they call a catalog of everything, which means they're keeping a lot of information about your photos in a database alongside your photos on the same drive as your photos. So as Lightroom is doing whatever the heck it's doing, it's accessing all of those at the same time. Over time, that's the big key here, over time, that information can get convoluted. It can get almost spaghettified, right? With information being spread out all over the place, not unlike a fragmented hard disk. As it turns out, Lightroom has this concept of optimizing your catalog. That is something that I would explicitly have you do before you exit Lightroom to make sure that that's the issue. In other words, you're facing this problem, things starting to slow down, optimize the catalog. Edit, preferences, performance, optimize catalog is what I found in my version of Lightroom Classic. If that solves your problem, well, now you know. You just need to do that every once in a while. Or I believe Lightroom will probably optimize the catalog on the way out when you shut it down, which means that if you're shutting it down and when you come back, everything's hunky-dory, probably the catalog optimization is what's needed. The bottom line here, though, is that I'm still really uncomfortable with this amount of data on an external drive. I understand you may have legitimate reasons for needing it to be on an external drive, but if you don't, you'll probably have a better experience overall if you can move that catalog, all of the pictures, all of the catalogs to an internal drive, especially if that internal drive is an SSD. That's what I would do. Bottom line, in order, confirm that the problem is being caused by the program you think it is, assuming that it is Lightroom, then make sure you're using a USB 3 interface for that external drive. That can make a dramatic impact on the ability of that drive to respond quickly. Please consider moving everything to an internal drive. That'll make an even bigger difference. Review any temporary or caching locations used by the program. I realize that's not necessarily an option for Lightroom, but in the event that this is occurring for someone else with other software, that's something to look at. And finally, instruct or allow the program to optimize any of the databases that it might be storing with your data on that external drive. Chances are that too will cause a good increase in speed. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/148162. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.